Trump about to drop a big one. It's on. President Trump's administration is discussing the possibility of dropping a big one. If things go as planned, there could be a strike on North Korea that gives them a slight jab to remind them who's in charge. It would be a strategic strike designed to provide them with a metaphoric bloody nose that reminds North Korea to stop testing their missiles, get their act together, and be better than what they are now. A few people are against it, but that's why the team is smartly weighing the options and imagining what happens in every possible scenario to ensure that any warning shot is kept at bay and does not spark a nuclear war. Their deliberation upon whether to drop a quick strike over at North Korea could be possibly labeled as high risk. However, if North Korea were to strike back, then they would likely be demolished. It's believed that North Koreans living under Kim Jong-un have horrible lives, living in a disastrous nation rife with defectors trying to escape. A bloody nose attack could turn into a beheading, as it's believed that North Korea would likely strike back. Jong-un's attitude toward Trump would likely force him to retaliate, even though he would permanently eliminate himself from the planet. Any strike back from Jong-un would be like him signing off on Dr. Kevorkian with an atomic bomb. Daily Mail reports. The Trump administration is deliberating the pros and cons of a possible strike on North Korea in what officials are calling a high-risk retaliation of future weapon tests, a new report says. The strike, described as bloody nose attack, may likely do more harm than good, and even ignite nuclear war, the Wall Street Journal revealed of the possible plan. President Trump's National Security Advisor Herbert Raymond McMaster is pushing for the strike, while Secretary of State Rex Tillerson and Secretary of Defense James Mattis are urging against the decision. On Saturday, Lieutenant General McMaster acknowledged in an interview with the New York Times that the country's leader Kim Jong-un's weapons program's development has been quicker and the timeline is a lot more compressed than most people believed. McMaster said, "We have to do everything we are doing with a greater degree of urgency, and we have to accelerate our own efforts to resolve the issue short of conflict." A spokesman for the Director of National Intelligence, however, told the outlet that the intelligence community was not caught off guard with the leader's accelerated pace. "Any suggestion that we didn't see these tests coming is dead wrong," Brian P. Hale said. "The intelligence community has always assessed that Kim Jong-un is firmly committed to developing a nuclear capability. North Korea's weapons testing seems to be the problem. If they're not supposed to be testing certain types of weapons, such as nukes with anthrax attached, then there is a likely chance that a nation would respond with action. When countries agree to terms regarding nuclear weapons and missiles, then each country should follow the rules. Upon not following the rules, the nation who breaks their terms could face punishment. Perhaps the bloody nose attack in the form of a quick rocket jab to North Korea will have them calm down with their missile testing." North Korea tested an ICBM Hwasong-15 missile that's rumored to travel about 8,000 miles from North Korea to Washington. North Korea should focus on providing their people with a culturally sound and protective nation to live in. From what we read about, it sounds like the people are miserable living under a dictatorship. Is it worth it for North Korea to test ICBMs, or should they focus on their people and making North Korea great again? Daily Mail continues. The intelligence community also said 34-year-old Kim was young, inexperienced and distrusted by his military, according to the outlet. Aside from the said setbacks, a forensic expert who analyzed Kim's voice has also newly suggested he may be suffering health complications. Chungnam State University professor Cho Dong-yuk sampled Kim's voice in an audio test, which revealed the overweight smoker and drinker could likely be suffering from kidney disease. Cho explained in a statement that while his heart and lungs tested okay, at least, the samples show that his kidneys are weaker than other organs. Inexperienced and not trusted by his military doesn't speak well for Kim Jong-un. It sounds like he should be playing Xbox Live with some 10-year-old boys. Maybe he could get himself a headset and copy of the latest shooter game. Any move by North Korea will ultimately destroy the existence of their nation. The world is tired of their nonsense. It's time for them to man up and be better leaders, or put their hands up and prepare for a fight. I predict a knockout in round one. In round one.